I've got some serious questions to ask you. The chairman of the January 6th committee, Chairman Thompson, and John Katko, who was the emissary of Kevin McCarthy, negotiated an agreement for an independent outside commission with five Democrats, five Republicans, equal subpoena power, right down the middle. And yet Donald Trump decided he didn't like it because he doesn't want anybody investigating January the 6th. So he turned against it, and then the Republican leadership flipped over and turned against it. I think you voted against that commission. Why did you vote against that commission?
For many of the reasons that I've discussed today, that the focus on January 6th, the obsession
so you don't want to know.
Is unwarranted.
You don't want to know anymore.
Look, I think we have
okay, let me ask you about that.
We have a process in Article 3 where the courts get to determine those issues. If the United States government brings charges, people can resolve those in the courts.
You don't want to know.
That's not okay with you guys because you want to politicize
Gaetz,
it because you
I know you too well for this. You don't want to know the answer. You don't want
you guys
to
don't
know.
Have an answer.
No, no, so let me, Mr. Gaetz, let me ask you. Let me ask you a serious question.
The stenographer is trying to take people's words down, and she can't if everybody talks over each other. Okay. So
our apologies to the stenographer.
Okay.
We're going to do
you.
It civilly, like two lawyers. Okay, Mr. Gaetz, let me ask you this: let's say that the exact same attack had taken place. Let's assume 145 of our officers were beaten in the face with baseball bats, steel pipes, Confederate battle flags, etc. Let's say they interrupted the counting of Electoral College votes for the first time in American history for 4 or 5 hours. Let's say marauders, insurrectionists came into our building and chanted for hanging Vice President Mike Pence. But let's just change the hypothetical. This one element, Mr. Gaetz, let's say it wasn't the Proud Boys. Let's say it wasn't the Oath Keepers. Let's say it wasn't the Three Percenters. Let's say it wasn't the Aryan Nations. Let's say it was Al-Qaeda or ISIS. Would you really not want an investigation into what happened with that attack on America?
If Al-Qaeda or ISIS attacked the U.S. Capitol, I would think that the least capable institution to bring them to justice would be this January 6th committee.
You would not want...
I would far prefer the legal process to play out or the military process to play out. If the American people had to rely on the Congress itself as an institution to protect us from ISIS without law enforcement, without the military,
yeah.
We would be in deep, deep trouble.
Okay, is that a new position for you and Mr. Jordan? Because I know you guys have been
involved... It's a new hypothetical.
Yeah, you've been involved in a lot of different investigations, both of you. For example, does Benghazi ring a bell?
I was, I believe, a law student at the Great William and Mary Law
School. All right. Well, let me. But before I come to Mr. Jordan, let me ask you this: do you think that people who are subpoenaed by a court or by the United States Congress, who think in their head that they might have a privilege or someone else might have a privilege, have the right just not to show up?
I believe that people have the right to allow the legal process to
okay.
resolve whether
but you know how that works, Mr.
Gaetz.
You're a lawyer. You know how that
very
works.
Much so.
You,
you
show
know
up.
It works too.
Wait a second,
you know
Mr. Gaetz. Wait, hold on. Let's try to educate the public here.
Please.
Because people need to know. If you're subpoenaed, you go. If you think you have a privilege, for example, let's say Steve Bannon says, you know what? I'm guilty as hell. I don't want to testify against myself. In America, you don't have to. The Fifth Amendment privilege against self-incrimination says, I plead the Fifth. I might incriminate myself, but you know what? You got to go. And you got to answer each specific question. Some of them might implicate your Fifth Amendment rights, and some of them might not. Even if he thinks he's got, in some surreal parallel universe, a presidential executive privilege, even though he didn't even work for the White House at that point, he'd been fired by Donald Trump in August of 2017. This is in January of 2021, in December of 2020. But even if he thought that, he's got to come before the committee, and he has to plead it. Do you not agree with that?
No, I think that...
No, honestly, do you not agree with that?
Mr. Yeah. Raskin, I allowed you to speak, and I didn't interrupt you. I hope I'm given the same opportunity.
Just give me the honest answer.
The honest answer is that the McGahn litigation that you and I both followed closely as members of the Judiciary Committee actually is the path forward. McGahn didn't have to show up to assert that he was waiting for legal...
The president asserted executive privilege on his
now
behalf.
Now, you're the one giving challenges to the stenographer. So,
I'm telling you, wait a second. I'm going to elaborate on your answer here.
I haven't even given my full answer yet.
That's not how it works in the Rules Committee, Mr. Gaetz. Just follow this then.
Well, wait,
the president.
Do I get to respond to these?
Mr. Gaetz, I'm going to give you the chance to respond.
Well, it
respond
sound like sounds like you
President Trump asserted executive privilege.
If I
President Trump asserted executive privilege for McGahn. President Biden has not asserted.
I believe there is.
Has not asserted executive privilege. President Trump has initiated litigation.
Look, the reason you all waited on McGahn is because the Russia hoax wasn't going well for you. And the reason you're not waiting now is because you have no other legislation for the country.
All right,
that's
Mr. Jordan, let me switch to you.
You had the McGahn playbook, but you've ditched it because you guys need January 6th so bad.